In this video, we introduced the Lorentz force law, describing the direction and magnitude of the magnetic force exerted on a charged particle moving through a magnetic field. We follow up with a series of qualitative questions on the direction of magnetic force, and we're going to cover quantitative questions in several other videos, and I'll just post links to those when they're ready. So in the picture on the left, I have a magnetic field pointing up. I have a charged particle with a positive charge moving through that magnetic field at some angle with respect to the magnetic field. Looks like it's in the neighborhood of 45 degrees, and there's my velocity vector, and my speed would be V. So it turns out the magnetic force is given by this Lorentz force law. The magnetic force is proportional to the size of the charge. Interestingly enough, it's proportional to the speed itself. So if you double the speed of the particle, the force doubles. And of course, the force is proportional to the strength of the magnetic field. And then it has this sine theta term in it. And what this does is it means that the magnetic force is going to be zero if the velocity is parallel to the magnetic field, because that would make this angle zero. And it's going to be maximized if the angle is 90 degrees. For those of you with a little more calculus or physics experience, you might prefer to write this as a cross product. And that cross product actually has the direction of the magnetic force folded into it. In this video, we're going to talk about how to get the direction of the magnetic force using what are called right-hand rules. And I've shown three different methods here. It's not really clear what's going on in each one until I really explain it. But there are three different relatively popular ways of figuring out the direction of magnetic force. So in each case, strangely enough, the magnetic force is perpendicular to both the velocity and the magnetic field. And then you have to figure out exactly which way it points. In our original picture here, the only way to be perpendicular to both the magnetic field and the velocity is for the force to either be pointing out of the page or into the page. And the right-hand rule is designed to help you make that decision. I'll call the first one method one. And in method one, you think of your fingers as the magnetic field lines. I tried to get my fingers to point straight up, but I guess they're kind of crooked. You let your thumb point in the direction of the velocity vector. And when you orient your hand in this way, the magnetic force is going to point straight out of your palm, which means the answer here is that the magnetic force is pointing out of the page. This introduces a complication. Because the magnetic force is so truly three-dimensional, we need a new notation for vectors that point in and out of the page. So real quick, this is what the notation is. If you see a dot with a circle around it, that means out of the page. And that's supposed to represent the tip of the arrow, because after all, vectors are arrows. If you see an X with a circle around it, that's into the page, and that represents the tail feathers of the arrow. So our answer using method one here is that the magnetic force is pointing out of our palm and out of the page. In method number two, and this is the one that seems to be the most popular in textbooks, but it's just not the way I learned it, so I don't really use it very often. You take your index finger and let that point in the direction of the velocity vector. Your middle finger points in the direction of the magnetic field. And in order to line your hand up this way, you've got to make a choice on how your thumb is oriented. And the orientation of your thumb gives you the direction of the magnetic force. And it's the same answer. My thumb is pointed up here. I'll just put the force vector on the tip of my thumb. Now, method number three is the one that I actually use in practice. And I think it's because it's more the way that you visualize a cross product in multivariable calculus. That's probably how it started. And it's very similar to method two. It's just that instead of putting your index finger one way and your middle finger the other, you treat it as a motion. So I orient my fingers in the direction of the velocity, and then I sweep my fingers out in an inward motion, so in the palmward direction, until they line up with B. And the only way to rotate my hand that way is to have my thumb oriented in the correct direction for the force. So this one involves motion, which makes it a little more complicated to deal with in a video. Again, I get an outward force out of my thumb. And I'll just roll a clip real quick to illustrate how the motion works. Okay, let's get into our examples. In example A, I have a magnetic field pointing to the left. I have a velocity of a charged particle pointing up. Now you can take your choice of these three methods. The one I'm usually going to show is method three, because that's the way I'm most comfortable doing it. So what I do is figure out how can I align my fingers in the direction of V and sweep out to the direction of B through an angle less than 180 degrees. If you try to do this the wrong way, you're going to sprain your wrist. And so the clip looks like this. And the only way to get it done was to have my thumb sticking out of the page, so that's the direction of the force vector. In example B, I have a magnetic field into the page and a velocity to the right. I figure out how to orient my right hand, so I can sweep my fingers out from the direction of V to the direction of B without spraining my wrist. And the only way to do that is for my thumb to be pointing upward, so there's the direction of the force again. Again, I encourage you to check out these other methods too. Like for example, I could put my fingers pointing into the page for the magnetic field lines, my thumb pointing to the right, and then my palm would point straight upward. I get the same answer. C is exactly the same as B, except I switched it to a negative charge. So remember the rule is, if the charge is negative, you just get the opposite result for the magnetic force. And then finally, in part D, I have a velocity at some angle, and I have a magnetic field that's pointing out of the page. So I try to orient my hand in a way that allows me to sweep out with my fingers in the direction of V to the direction of B. So my fingers pointing up and to the right and then sweeping out of the page. And that gives me a magnetic force in this direction. Now again, the right hand rules, they give you pretty much the right direction, but you're not going to orient your hand perfectly. You can perfect your answer by remembering that the magnetic force is always going to be perpendicular to the velocity vector and to the magnetic field lines. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.